As of October 13th of 2024, there are currently 47 volcanoes which are actively erupting around the planet, a total which is the same number as were erupting last week, including at least two volcanoes on each continent. One of these erupting complexes can be found in southern Japan on the island of Kyushu, where the Sakurajima volcano towers several thousand feet above the middle of Kagoshima Bay. Sakurajima used to be a true island until it was connected due to a lava flow with Kyushu in 1914. Sakurajima is the youngest vent of a large caldera complex known as the Ira Caldera and produces frequent volcanic explosions which often eject bombs of lava. And now, here are this week's top volcano-related news stories. In the Caribbean nation of Saint Vincent and the Grenadines, a suspicious thermal signature was detected at the La Soufriere volcano, which famously produced a major explosive eruption in 2021, causing further investigations to be made. Heading to the southern hemisphere in Argentina, an alert was issued at the Copahue volcano, which warned of an increased risk of a completely unpredictable phreatic eruption occurring. And, in what is this week's top story, something unusual is occurring at Mount Adams, a glacier-covered active volcano situated in south-central Washington state. As, during the last month, the rate of what are referred to as volcano tectonic earthquakes underneath its edifice has dramatically increased to a rate 180 times higher than what is normal. While typically, Mount Adams would experience a single volcano tectonic earthquake about once every 2.5 years, the last month has instead seen 6 such volcano tectonic earthquakes strike underneath its edifice. For context, this is still a low figure when compared to other regional volcanoes, but is still regardless quite a development for a volcano that many geologists, including myself, place near the very bottom among Cascade volcanoes in terms of odds of producing an eruption by the year 2100. This activity caused the U.S. Geological Survey to release an information statement regarding the situation, alongside quickly placing 4 additional seismic stations near the volcano, with the latter being important in case very small magnitude earthquakes were previously getting missed. However, I am not of the opinion that these events are likely related to the movement of magma, although it is possible. I say this for 3 reasons. A lack of recent ground deformation, the fact that Mount Adams's magma chamber is off-center to the east, and yet the earthquakes are clustered on its western side at a minimum of a mile too shallow to be likely associated with magma movement. This suggests several possibilities, ranging from slow, undetected landslide creep, magmatic intrusion, or non-magmatic activity causing increased heat flow into the volcano's hydrothermal system, to possibly a correlation with at least decade-high rainfalls the volcano experienced earlier in June and July seeping into the ground and generating earthquakes. Regardless, for now, Mount Adams is rightfully remaining at an alert level of green or normal, as well unusual, no true definitive volcanic activity or new and fresh magma has been detected. Meanwhile, on the island of Saint Vincent, despite having not erupted since a major explosive eruption which ended in April of 2021, attention temporarily was focused on the La Soufriere volcano. Well, a satellite heat signature, likely indicating a new ground temperature upwards of 100 degrees Celsius, was unexpectedly detected on October 6, which persisted through the following day. This could have represented minor release of magma or magmatic fluids beneath the still cooling and settling lava flows and pyroclastic flows created in 2021, a rockfall exposing hot material which was previously buried, new volcanic unrest, or even a small phreatic eruption. Yet, upon further analysis, increased volcanic unrest or a new eruption was ruled out as no other suspicious activity was recorded at the volcano, with gas and earthquake levels remaining at normal values and vent temperatures remaining at expected levels. And, in South America, an alert was issued regarding Argentina's Copahue volcano, suggesting a medium-term increased likelihood of a phreatic eruption occurring there. The cause of this alert was not a new and sudden episode of volcanic unrest, but rather the conclusion of long-term observations made over multiple decades at the Copahue volcano. It was discovered that during the driest months, which happen to be the winter in Argentina, its crater lake largely disappears. As this occurs, increased concentrations of native sulfur exist in the liquid solution, eventually reaching a point that this sulfur can solidify and clog and then seal the magma conduit. Once this occurs, pressure can build up and unexpectedly produce a phreatic eruption. Here is a quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on October 12th of 2024. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.